YouTube. Okay, first of all, what brings you to YouTube on Christmas Day? Huh? Like, I'm guessing that, well, hopefully no kids are on here because, hopefully kids are busy with actual Christmas stuff. But if kids stumble upon here, it's because, like, maybe they didn't get the present they wanted, or maybe you guys got all the presents you wanted, but you're already bored with it. Man, attention span not very high for kids these days. And then there's also the possibility that, let's see, maybe you're alone this Christmas. Like, that's what brings me here, making a video. My kids are at their dad's house. My river is, I don't even know where they are right now. But anyway, and I have another step daughter and two granddaughters in a far off land. And so anyway, I'm alone this Christmas, and my family lives all over. We live in all the four different time zones. And so anyway, I kind of like it though. Like, I mean, okay, I wanted to go to my I wanted to go hang out with a friend this Christmas, but I don't have a vehicle and my wheelchair wouldn't go that far. So, anyway, so I'm here and I'm hanging out with you. And so maybe you're alone too for a series of unfortunate events or fortunate events. Maybe you wanted to be alone on Christmas because you know what? Christmas is a whole lot of hype. Like, really? I mean, what's I don't know. I'm kind of like, okay, so what I'm doing, hanging out on the bed. Ooh, you can see my, like, actual skin. Did you know that somebody paid me once, like, I don't know, $200 or something for a video of taking my socks off? But I needed the cash. Sorry. Why not? I can take my socks off. But anyway, yeah, people do weird stuff, and so maybe you have your own weird or not so weird reasons for why you're alone on Christmas. Or maybe you're with a bunch of family and you guys are all like watching YouTube together. Oh, yay! Nobody does that, right? Like, have you guys ever seen that show that's called Black Mirror? It's good. I like it a lot. I've been binge watching that a lot, and then I think I'm done with the series right now. So now I'm watching Something Grace. It's like a Netflix show about this girl that, she's like in jail for murder or something. But it's a good story. And I'm writing. Like, I've been writing a lot lately. What I need to do, because it's almost the first of the year. Okay. After the holidays are all completely over, then I want to submit my children's book to 4RV Publishing. I know the company, and I know the, like, the people over there, and they are interested in my idea. And so anyway, I need to format it and all this stuff. I need to polish it up, finish it, kind of, because the story, I could go farther with it, but I kind of want it to be a children's book series, and so maybe I will do eventually. The problem, but I'm also writing another horror story. And that one, I think that, like, right now it's a really short story. It's like only, I don't know, 3,500 words or something. It's really short. But I'm thinking maybe I should just get more in depth with the characters and make it into like a actual novel, because I think the concept is really good. And I can't tell you because people will steal my idea, because, you know, it's brilliant, as all my ideas are. Unfortunately, the world in general doesn't always agree with my idea of brilliance. And so they don't always work out as well as I optimistically believe that they will. But anyway, and then also I finally got done making River's Name and Lights, which, you know, I made that video. That was fun to make and fun to do, and I'm glad it's done and stuff. But now I was thinking, like, maybe on Christmas, maybe I should start really focusing on my art, like make today about giving back and spread a little Christmas joy. Like, just put a couple of smiles up. I can make some smiles with the cap rings, and I found so many wires and stuff. Sometimes I find these wires that it's like a rectangle without one of the sides. It's just from some kind of sign. And anyway, I want to bend those into a smile. And so I'm thinking, like, maybe I should just bundle up really well and dress so warm and go ride around town putting smiles up. But also, like, oh yeah, but I found this thing on the road that's like some kind of canister that got all smashed and stuff, but it's the perfect robot eye. So I have a robot coming soon to the streets and more. But I don't know how I'm gonna put that up. I think maybe I can zip tie it. I don't know. But I'm trying to think of ways that I can, like, you know, reach out to others this Christmas too. And so that's part of why I'm making video. Because I was like, surely I'm not the only person who's alone on Christmas. But even if you are alone, or if you're not, I don't know. I hope you think of ways that you can reach out to other people too. Another thing that I really need to do, I bought a bag of little bells and all different kinds of pipe cleaners, and I'm making cat toys. And, like, it's awesome. I'll make a video sometime showing my little cat toys. Okay, maybe they aren't awesome. I'm sorry. Like, sometimes I don't know, I wonder if I'm, like, narcissistic, or you know, if I think too much of myself, because I'm always like, oh, it's so awesome, my art is so beautiful, or so perfect, or so cool, or I can dance, you know, I'm amazing. Even though, like, I know I can't dance, I know I can't sing. I used to be able to sing a long time ago. I was good at singing, you know, maybe not like super good, but I was okay at singing, but not anymore, because now I'm old and I just go, ah, you know, like old people do. Not saying all old people do. I've heard some old people with beautiful voices, so sorry, all you old people. Old people rock, and that's why my parade sign says old people like candy too. Because that's a very big thing. Okay, so why am I here? I should be writing or something. Like, it feels really good to stretch out. And so that's like what I'm doing. And I'm probably gonna binge watch shows instead of writing. I need to write my own story. Like, maybe I will. Maybe I'll start working on my horror story, because it's fun. But I'm also writing a fictional autobiography, and I was working on that the other day, too. So, like, yay, at least I have been writing a little bit. That's good. Good. My counselor, I see a counselor, because taking care of your mental health is just as important as taking care of your physical health. Probably even more so. And so, anyway, my counselor wants me to focus on, like, incorporating the things that really make me feel good into my daily life and like prioritizing my health and stuff. And so stretching out is really good. I've got my leg, like you see how my left leg is right now. I have it like where one, okay, my right leg is on the wheelchair and then my left leg is off on the back. It's because like my butt, that leg never wants to outstretch. It always wants to bend in or stay straight. It's really hard to get it to stretch out this way. And so, like, I figured out that, okay, I can kind of straddle the wheelchair, and then it helps me to move around. Also, just a random note, I'm on a checker right now because I don't have a diaper on or anything. I wanted to free it because, you know, it feels good with nothing. And I got this app called like a period tracker, which is awesome because I always forget when my period is supposed to start, and I always think it's supposed to start early. And so that's why I actually wore a diaper to the end of the day, because I was like, oh, my period's probably going to start tonight. Which, of course, not, and I have the little period tracker thing, that it said, okay, you still have 8 days or whatever, so yay, good for that, so I can be free. and I have a bag full of catheter supplies right next to me, so, and what I've been doing lately, too, with catheters, is empty bottles. Like, I save empty bottles, and then have duct tape everywhere, which actually I don't know where my duct tape is, but I don't know if I have any with me, but I tape them on. I tape the end of the catheter onto the bottle, so that way I don't have to worry about spilling the bottle accidentally or whatever, because I only have two hands, and sometimes it's hard to hold a bottle and hold a catheter, and, like, I don't know why that's hard. That shouldn't be hard, but it is. So, just trust me on that. Alright, fine. I should go. I'm gonna write and, like, judge. And, no, seriously, I want to write my books. Alright, bye.